So, class 2, today we are going to start your chapter 3. The name of the chapter is subtraction. So, ABC, looking back, ABC in class 1 you did small subtraction like if we subtract same number then the answer will be 0, like 11 minus 11, 0. If we do 4 minus 4, 0. Or now if we subtract the previous number, just like 4 minus 3, then the answer will be 1. Previous number means if you subtract 10 minus 9, 1, 100 minus 99, 1. Like that, you can think that previous number, if we subtract, then the answer is always 1. And if we subtract same number, the answer always is 0. So now if we see 15 minus 10, so 15 minus 10 is after 10, you count up to 15. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 5. So the answer is 5. And if there is 0, 0 in the last, then you can subtract 5 minus 4. As I told you, previous number, if we subtract 1, 5 minus 4 is 1 and 0 will be like this. So 50 minus 40 is 10. Now this is the subtraction in the line or horizontal subtraction, we can say. And this is in the column, or you can write in, you can say vertical. So first method using the lines. How to subtract? First method I am telling you using the line. So just if it is 4 minus 3, then you draw 4 line, 1, 2, 3, 4, and cut 3 lines, 1, 2, 3. 3 line we are cutting. What is left? That is 1. If we go for this one, 10 minus 5. 10 minus 5, you draw the 10 lines and cut 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 line if you cut, then how many left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So answer is 5. Same way you can do yourself these two parts, 9 minus 8 and 7 minus 3. Now we will go to the next second method for the subtraction. We can use our fingers to subtract as we were using the fingers for add. Same way. Just like it, if it is 8 minus 5, just open your 8 fingers, 8 fingers, and close your 5 fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How much left? 3. So the answer will be 3. And if you go for 6 minus 3, just open your 6 fingers. 5 plus 1, 6. And just close 3 fingers. How much left? 1, 2, 3. So the answer will be 3. Same way, if 10 are there, open your both the hands, 10 fingers, then close your 7 fingers. The left fingers will be 3. So this is subtraction by using fingers. You can practice for these two parts. You can pause the video and do the left parts. Now third method, by counting forward from down. That is better. That is also very easy method and better method to do. So if it be you have 14 minus 10, 10. You see 10 is downside. 10 you can circle and count forward up to 14. After 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So the answer will be 4. So you can write 4. 20, 36 minus 23. Now you can separate. You can count from 3 to 6. 3 to 6. After 3, 4, 5, 6. So you can write here 3. And if 2 to 3 you count, after 2, 3, 1. So 1 it is. And if you want to open the finger, open 6 finger, close 3, then 3 will be left. Open 3 finger, close 2, 1 will be left. Now 9 minus 5. You know, after 5 you count up to 9. 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is also the way you can use any of the method. You can use either by using fingers, or you can count forward, or you can draw the lines. So rest of the two parts for you. Just try to use fingers for these two parts. Now next last part is for the method to use for the subtraction is using number line. You have to draw a number line for this by using a scale. Take a scale, draw a line. And if it is 11 minus 4, that 0, you just draw these points by using the points like centimeter scale, 0, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, like that. And you directly go 0 to 11, directly 11. Then come 4 step back, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this answer is 7. So backward, you have to come backward in this. In addition, you have to go forward. In subtraction, you have to come backward. So 12, 11, you reach that 7. So answer is 7. So same way, you can do this 12 minus 7 yourself, or you can do more parts, 2-3 parts you can use for this. Now I will show you this full page. You can pause and you can do. I will show you subtraction on the number line by using a scale. Just like we did just now. 11 minus 4. This is a number line scale. 0 to 11 we will go directly. 0 to 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 11 here. In the middle, we will keep 11 here. Then second pointer, we will bring 7 step, 4 step back. 1, then it is at 10, 2, 3, 4. You reach that 7. So this number scale also you can use like an activity for this one, number line subtraction. Now we will go to the your book side. In your book, you can see this first question is given that count back to subtract. You have to count back, start from the bigger number. Just like 11 is there, count 3 backs, backward. 11, 10, 9. No, 10, 9, 8. You will reach at 8. Same way you can do the second part. Now number line is there. 64 minus 9. Circle 64. 64 is here. And go 9 step back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You will reach at 55. Same way you can do the second part. Now use an addition factor to solve. Addition factor to solve means just like 10 minus 3 is what? You know 10 minus 3 is 7. Because 7 plus 3 is 10. Because 7 plus 3 is 10. So this is the relation between subtraction and addition. If I say that 5 minus 4 is 1, it means 4 plus 1 is 5. So now you can subtract here by using any of the method. I am using here that forward counting method. 3. Circle 3, count from 3 to 9. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it is 6 here, and here 4 you can bring down as it. Now here, in this part, 0 minus 0 is 0, and 7 minus 1. You can, you know, if 1 you subtract, you will get the previous number, 6. And same way you can do other parts, C, D, E, yourself. Now we'll go to the next piece. Directly to exercise 3A, there are some word problems. So first question is, solve, remember to put the bigger number on the top. 12 boxes, 6 are open. 12 boxes, total boxes are 12 here and 6 are open. How many are closed? You know, if 6 are open, then after 6 you count up to 12. 6 plus 6 is 12. So, or you can count here also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 are left, that is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which are closed. But I suggest you to do this question in the notebook. I am writing here notebook and make the statement like this. Exercise 3A. Number of boxes is equal to 12. Number of open boxes is equal to 6. Then you have to find number of closed boxes. After 6, you count up to 12. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can write here 6. This way also you can do. And here, the second question is, if you see in this one book, it is, how many less pencils than eraser? We have to count, there are 32 eraser and 16 pencils. So how to make statement for this one? Number of erasers is equal to 32 and number of pencils is equal to 16. And then how less number of pencils is equal to, now if you know the subtraction by using borrow, then it is good. Otherwise, after 16, you can count up to 32. If you count, now you I didn't tell you about the subtraction by using this one, borrow. So you can count from 16 to 32. 16 to 32, if you count, the answer is 16. Or a second method is, if you want to do by using borrow, that I will tell you later on. In the next exercise, then borrow is like this. If 6 is greater than 2, then you have to take a borrow from here, it becomes 12, and here this 3 becomes 2 because 1 is taken towards 2. So 12 minus 6 is 6, 2 minus 1 is 1. So this way also you can do. Next question is, next question in the book is, how many more stamps are than marbles? Stamps are given 98 and marbles are given 75. So we can write number of stamps is equal to 98, number of marbles is equal to 75, more stamps. So you can subtract 8 minus 5, 8 finger up, 5 close, or you can count after 5 to 8, 6, 7, 8, 3. After 7 you count up to 9, 8, 9, 2, 23. So this way you can do exercise 3A. So now we will go to the next page. Page number 46. In this page, they have shown add and subtract, the relation between addition and subtraction. Just like 7 plus 4 is, after 7 you count 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 4, that is 11. Now 4 plus 7 is also 11, that is same, 7 plus 4 is equal to 11, 4 plus 7 is also 11. Now if you subtract, then 11 minus 7 is 4, okay. After 7 you count up to 11, or you can use this relation. Okay, if 7 is here, what should be downside? 4, if 11 is up, or you can count from 7 to 11. 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, so 4. You can use these also, these circles also. 11 circle, then cut 7 circle, 4 will be left. And if you cut 4 circle, then 7 will be left. So this way you can do the whole page. Now the last one is also, I can tell you. Now if you do 8 plus 5, use this table here. For this, these all, 8 plus 5 is 13, we all know, and 5 plus 8 is also 13. But if you subtract 13 minus 5, 13 minus 5, the left number will be the answer 8. And if you subtract 13 minus 8, left number will be the answer, that is 5. This way you can do this side also. Now we will go to the next exercise. Now this is called as 100 grid. 100, what is 100 grid? The numbers are written in the columns starting from 1 to 100, and these numbers can be used for this grid can be used for addition and subtraction. If you want to add and subtract, I want to tell you the use of the grid. Just like if you want to add this 11 plus 10, so 11 plus 10, if we go, the downside number is add plus 10 only. Okay, so 11 plus 10 is 21. If we want to add 21 plus 20, example I am giving, then two step down you will go. 1, 2. Here plus 10, plus 10. Means 20, the answer will be 41. And if you want to subtract, if I say you subtract 91 minus 71. So you circle first 91 and go back side. 1, 2. If you go two step, these grids, the difference is 10, 10, 10. Downside difference is everywhere 10, 10, 10. 3 plus 10, 30. 13 plus 10, 23, 32. So two step you are going, so answer is 20. So this way we can use, this method we can use for exercise 3B. They are asking you that complete the following table using the number grid. So if we see the number grid 67 in the grid, 67, backside 10 and forward 10, plus 10, minus 10, plus 10. You have to go there in the grid page here and circle where is 67. You just find 67 is here. Circle it. 67 minus 10 means the previous upside number 57, and plus 10 means downside number 77. Same way, if other number is 68 will be there, then 58 minus 10, 58 plus 10, this one. And if plus 20 is there, then you go two step. Plus 30 is there, you go three step. Plus like this, for subtraction you go upside, and for addition you go downside, forward. Addition is forward counting and subtraction is backward counting. So if we see the grid, we have seen 67 minus 10 is 57, and here it is 77. If 19, we will say backside is 9 and forward is 29. You can see the grid backside. 90 backside 10, upside 80. Or you can think like this also, 9 is there, 9 minus 1, 8, and 9 plus 1, 10, and put a 0 as it, 2 minus 1, 1, and 1 as it, and 2 plus 1, 3, 31. And this is same thing is in the grid also. If you go for 20, then 2 step back, 3 is there, 2 step back means 3 to 2 to 1. Okay, so 1, 4, and 2 step forward, 3 plus 2, 4, 5, downside. So 54, you can see the grid also, 2 step back, 4 minus 2 is 2, and 9, and 4, 2 step forward, 20, it is 69. 2 step backward, 1, 2, and 2 step forward, 5 2. Okay, now we will go to the 30. In 30 you have to see 3 step backward, 4 minus 3.